Hi, I'm Amy, and today I am going to tell you some of the best free websites you can use for genealogy research, as well as a few that are worth paying for. I'm going to give you my 25 most visited websites as I conduct research for other people. So, stay tuned for some professional secrets. All right, so let's get started. As a professional researcher, I am on my computer every day looking to build clients' trees and helping them solve genealogy problems. And when I'm doing that, I am pretty much on like 25 main sites most of the time. So today we're going to talk about those sites. A lot of them are free, and I love free sites, but a few of them cost. I'm going to talk about those that cost and why it's worth it, and maybe some alternatives if you don't want to spend the money. So I'm going to go in order of my most visited websites to maybe the least visited. There are tons of other sites that I'm not going to get to today, but these are my 25 most often visited sites. So before we get started, please click like if this video is of help to you, and please subscribe. It really helps me out to have more subscribers. I'll get some more visibility on YouTube, as well as when you're a subscriber, you know about when I have a new video coming up. So please subscribe. All right, let's get started. Ancestry. I know Ancestry costs and it's not cheap, but Ancestry is the most user-friendly website for people that want to build trees. It's so easy to use. I build trees on it every day. I have right now 4 pages of trees and I just got rid of a couple of pages. So I build my trees on Ancestry. Now, I know that's not free, and for some people that's really a stopping point. Did want to let you know that a lot of times you can go to your public library and use Ancestry. That doesn't help very much while we're still isolating with the pandemic, but you can also use other at-home genealogy programs if you really don't want to use a site like Ancestry. The two that I really recommend are Family Tree Maker and Roots Magic. Family Tree Maker has a minimal cost. Roots Magic has a version that's free. So you can Google those and check those out. Anyway, so Ancestry, super easy to navigate. They have great sources, just a great website, really a great website. They have a ton of records out there. So here is one of my teaching trees on Ancestry. You can go into your individuals and you can look at hints and add sources and, you know, search for more sources. I just like the way it's laid up. It's really quick for me to build a tree. It's why I use Ancestry. The next website that I use, and I use this as much as Ancestry, probably really close second, is FamilySearch. As you build a tree, you incorporate it into kind of a global tree. And some people get upset because they work on a tree there and then somebody else changes that information. And it really makes them angry. Okay, I get that. But the purpose of the tree is to have a global collaborative tree. So the reason I don't recommend people building their tree solely on FamilySearch is because somebody can change it. And you may not remember where it was and what it was. So FamilySearch, great tree possibilities. Definitely look at it. You can work on building a tree there, but then download the free Roots Magic app or Roots Magic program, excuse me, and that will sync with FamilySearch. And then that way you have a place where you know what you've done. And if somebody messes around with the tree on FamilySearch, it's not gonna mess up your tree on Roots Magic on your computer. So if you wanna use FamilySearch tree, that's what I would recommend. But I really don't spend a lot of time on my tree on FamilySearch. I spend a lot of time on their other features, and I wanna show those to you super quickly. So search right up here at the top. You can search for records, but that's not where I go. I go to the catalog. This catalog is great, and when you use the catalog, you wanna go big to small. So I am going to say California. And I'm going to say Ventura because we're looking at the county level. So this is Ventura County. I'm going to click search. And this shows me all of the records. And there's not a lot here for Ventura. Other counties have lots more. That was a bad county to use as an example. So I am going to go to a different one. And I'm going to go to Cook County, Illinois. So I'm going to go back here to Illinois and I'm going to go to Cook. I'm going to update. Now we've got a whole lot more opportunities. See, I told you. Probate records, great records. And many of them you can see here on Family Search. Land and property, you can look at deeds. There's lots of different records. Vital records down here. 16 different vital records. And if you click on one of these, then you're going to get a chance to look at whether or not you can view these videos, or these videos, these records. If you do the search, you're gonna see if they have your person in there. This little key right here means you need to go to a family history library or an affiliate to view that record, and that's true of a lot of records in Illinois. But a lot of other states, that is not the case. So definitely check out the catalog on Family Search. The other thing are the wiki pages. So I can click on the country and then I can narrow it down and I can do that. I don't do it that way. What I do is I just do a Google search for, let's say I'm looking at back at Cook County. Cook County, Illinois genealogy is what I'll type into a research or a search query on Google. And usually the very first result is this wiki page on Family Search. These Family Search wiki pages are fantastic. They go over lots of information. They tell you when records began to be collected. They tell you when the county was formed and from what other counties it was formed. They tell you if there's a record loss and what happened to those records, how many records were destroyed. They'll give you other resources like African American resources, archives that are in the area. This wiki page will link you to other sources. Let me go down here to the vital records and you can just see there's a ton of information here. But if I go all the way down here to vital records, it's gonna link me to different places. Like here's some Cook County birth registers free. But if they'll also send you over to records like marriages on Find My Past, which is a pay-for website. They'll also link you to records on Ancestry. Anyway, wiki pages are an absolute must for any professional researcher, so it's something you should get familiar with. So, those are my two favorite Family Search places. The next site that I probably am really on the most often is newspapers.com. Now, I know this site is not free either, but it's a great website and you can do it for like a week for free. Give it a try, see what you think. It's also available in some of the libraries, but a free website that kind of can take its place is the Library of Congress Chronicling America. I knew I could get there. So Chronicling America is a wonderful newspaper website. It's very similar to newspapers.com and it's totally free. So if you have not been to this website before, you want to go. By the way, all of the links to all of these websites are down below in the show notes or in the description of this video. So just click the little arrow button underneath the video and you will find the links to these websites. All right, so next website is Fold 3. This costs as well. Newspapers.com and Fold 3 are owned now by Ancestry. Fold 3 does allow some records for free occasionally, particularly because Fold 3 specializes, they have a lot of records on there, but they really specialize in military records. And so when we have like Memorial Day or some other holiday where we celebrate those that have served in our military or armed forces, sometimes they'll offer a lot for free. So it's definitely a website you might want to check out, particularly certain times of the year. And again, on this one, you can do a 7-day free trial. So start a free trial period, hit those military records. There's also records here that are government records, like congressional records and things like that. So Fold 3 is a great website. A lot of libraries also offer this for free. And some libraries, like if you go to the Dallas Library, you can have access to this website at home for free by accessing it through your Dallas library. So check out your local library. You might be able to get on this website for free at home with that. So great little clue there. All right, this next website, people are gonna be surprised, but on Ancestry, you will see in some of the other websites, you will see Social Security records. You'll see Social Security application and claims database. You'll see the death database. And Social Security records are great. And sometimes on the Social Security application and claims database, you might see the names of parents. But what a lot of people don't know, this is a great professional secret, is that you can order an original Social Security, or an image of the original Social Security application. The individual has to be deceased, but because they do Social Security records, they know when they are deceased. And so if you find somebody in a Social Security record and you have the Social Security number, you include that when you place this order. It's processed through the Freedom of Information Act. And what you want is right here, request a copy of a deceased person's original application. It costs you a whopping $21. But let me tell you, I have found a lot of parents for individuals that we weren't able to find them otherwise. So, and most people were pretty honest about their parents on a government record like a Social Security card. So, great resource, one that's missed by a lot of people. Check that one out. All right, next is the National Archives. The National Archives is the place to go if you want to get military records. Depending on the type of record that you want, if you want a pension file, you're going to be here. Pension files are great files. If you have somebody that served in the Civil War, you want their pension file. If you have somebody that served in the Revolutionary War, their pension file is probably already on Fold 3. And if you have somebody that served for the Confederacy in the Civil War, a lot of those records are on Fold 3. But the National Archives will hold the rest of the pension files, as well as a lot of other records. So this is a great link to request military records. The National Archives is also a great place to just search for other records. It's not the easiest place to search for records, I'll be honest, digital records particularly, but it's definitely worth kind of looking around. All right, the next thing that I go to, well, this should be farther up on the list. This isn't in the right order, is Google searching. I Google search constantly. I am on Google all the time. I am searching for those wiki pages on FamilySearch. I am searching all sorts of other things. That's a whole nother video. So besides going on Google.com and Google.com and just doing a search, there's a couple of other Google sites I really like a lot. And one of them is Google Books. Google has been digitizing books for a long time, and they are great. They are great. They are great. There are a lot of good genealogy beneficial books that are not copyright protected anymore, and you can see the entire book online. So a lot of times I'll go to Google Books and look at those. FamilySearch also has a book section. You can look for books on FamilySearch. You can look for books at the Library of Congress. And you can look for books on HathiTrust, I think is how you say that. Here is the biographical history of Shelby and Audubon counties in Iowa. If you are a descendant of Alex Adams, which is a pretty common name, in Iowa, you want to look at this biography. Now, let me give you a warning about these biographies. They were done around the turn of the 19th century. Or is it the 20th century? I always get all that confused. Anyway, they were done about 1900. And they were kind of the who's who's that we had in the 1980s. But what they would do is somebody would come into town and they would say, if you want to be included in this book, you just pay this small amount of money and you can write this little section and we will include it in our book. So the information in the books is usually kind of what the family would want other people to know. It's not always accurate, but boy, there are some treasures within those sections. So these are great things to find. Now, sometimes the way I find these books is just doing a Google search. But the cool thing is that you can search within the text. You can do that on the Library of Congress if you're looking at a book on the Library of Congress, or you can do it like on HathiTrust right here by typing in some kind of word. So anyway, great thing to look for, and I spend a lot of time there. Here is this same book on Google Books. HathiTrust will only let you download a page, but Google Books will let you download the whole book. So a lot of times I'll try to find this on Google Books first because they're oftentimes the ones that HathiTrust are referring to anyway. The next Google page that I visit the most is the maps page. And I'll type in addresses onto this map page. I'll type in counties. Like if you type in a county like Shelby County, Tennessee, It will show me the current boundaries of that county, which gives me a really good idea of if I have a family in mind or a city in mind, or I want to look for cities within there. This is where I start. Now, this isn't an old map, and county boundaries have changed, but it gives me a good starting point to see, like, how far was it from one city to another city. The next one is Google Translate. When I am running across things that are in another language, whether it be Spanish or French, I'm on Google Translate. So that site I'm on a lot. This next site I'm not on quite as often, but when I need it, I need it, and it's Black's Law Dictionary. Now, this book, if you want to buy it, is super expensive because the one that you want is the fourth edition or earlier. The ones after that do not cover the old law terms that we're going to encounter in wills and deeds and any legal document that we're looking at in genealogy research. But the Black's Law Dictionary has them. So you don't have to spend a ton of money for this book. You can get it for free on this website. Look in the show notes and I'll send you right to this website. All right, another site that I really like is the Enumerator Instructions. I'm talking census records here. And the reason that this is so helpful is sometimes you are just not quite sure why a census taker might have written down something on a census record. Enumerator instructions can be really helpful when you're kind of struggling with a census record. All right, my next site is the Genealogy Bank. This is a paid site, but in Dallas, you can also access this site for free through their portal. If you go onto your Dallas Library portal, you can access this site for free as well. Your library may do the same for you. Genealogy Bank has a lot of great newspaper articles, a lot of obituaries that aren't found in other places. There are also a lot of other records in the Genealogy Bank. All right, another page that I love. This involves immigration. Stephen Morse has a lot of really great pages on his website, but this one I really like for immigration. So I'm gonna send you right to this particular page. All right, the next one I'm going to send you to is Archive Grid. Archive Grid will show you the archives in a particular area. And the reason this is helpful, it's kind of helpful for a couple things. One, you want to know what archives are near you? Check that out. But the other reason is, let's say that you are researching a particular area and you want to know what archives might be in this area. So when you're looking for archives, and I'm talking about that will include like all sorts of repositories, Archive Grid can be very helpful. All right, the next one is Behind the Name. And the reason I like this site, this is a free site, is you can put in a name and it'll give you the reason for the name. This helps a lot when you come across a foreign name and you don't know what it means, because maybe you want to find out what they may have changed the name to in the United States. Sometimes we have a foreign name, but we know they Americanized it, but we don't know what it is. So Behind the Name can help you out with that. All right, next one, BLM. BLM is a great, great website. BLM will show you this is the Bureau of Land Management, and the actual website is glorecords.blm.gov. Again, check the show notes. If you want to see if your ancestor received a land patent, maybe they bought the land through a patent office, or maybe they got a military land patent because they served in the military. This site is for you. This site will show you an actual picture of the original patent. It will show you exactly where that patent is on a map. And it will show you other survey notes and field notes that may have to do with that patent. Oh, so valuable. If you have never been to the BLM website and looked at patents, you're missing out. So I want to look at an interactive map of a particular state, or here we have of the United States. So I can see what it looked like in 1776. What did it look like in 1792? What did it look like in 1800? What did it look like in 1846? And it will show you how things go. Now, this is super helpful when you take it down to a state level, because it's gonna show you how a particular state was done. So if I just change this URL from United States to Kansas, it's going to show me the map of Kansas, the interactive map of Kansas County formation. So start in 1855 when Kansas became a state and it had those counties, but let's go and let's look in 1861. Let's look in 1865. Let's look in 18. Get the point? You just keep going. This is such a helpful website and it's free. I gotta love it. All right, the next one is David Remsey Map Collection. David Remsey's maps are free. David Remsey has put up a ton of absolutely beautiful maps. And here are the copyright information for his maps. They are licensed under the Creative Commons license, so you can download them and use them for your personal use. If you want to make reproductions of the maps, you've got to contact him. But, oh my gosh, really seriously, some beautiful maps. And if you want to look at an area where your ancestor may have lived and you want to look at what it looked like at the time, this is the place to go. All right, another site that's kind of fun is What Was There. This ties historical photos to Google Maps. Check it out, pretty cool. Now, my last two websites are DNA-oriented websites. The first one is The Genetic Genealogist. Blaine Bettinger is the industry standard in DNA research for genealogists. So I go to this page all the time because I want to see what this is. These numbers are centimorgans. I want to see what this is, the average centimorgan, and then this is the high and low that you would expect to see between an individual and their great grandparent. So I'm always like, I just hit the site all the time to look at this chart again. Another website that's pretty cool is DNA Painter. DNA Painter gives you a free account. You can upload your DNA information and they have all kinds of tools for you to analyze your information if you compare it to somebody else. And anyway, DNA Painter allows you to paint your segments of DNA so that you know if you have a match on this particular segment of your DNA. Once you know who that matches, anybody else that matches you in that area is going to be a relative through that ancestor. DNA Painter is pretty cool. All right, I've actually given you 26 or 27, I don't even know, I lost track, websites for you to check out. Most of these have been free. I hope they've been of help to you. Good luck with your genealogy research, and if you have some favorites, please put them in the comments section and share them with somebody else. Have a great day. Oh, don't forget, please subscribe. Sure appreciate it.